channel. One of the problems you will be asked to solve during an interview may focus on binary trees, and one of the most important topics associated with trees is the ability to traverse them. So, today we will attempt to explain how to traverse a binary tree one level at a time, and we'll implement this traversal technique. If you've watched our previous BFS video, you already know that the level order traversal of any graph can be retrieved by applying the breadth-first search algorithm on the given graph. And this is also true for trees. Take this entry as an example. The level order traversal of this tree is the list of nodes you see in front of you. When we previously implemented the BFS algorithm on graphs, we associated it with queues, and this also applies to trees. So, given the root node of a tree, what we will do is instantiate a queue and add the root node to it. Now, while this queue is still not empty, we will keep polling and adding child nodes to it until all the nodes are traversed and printed to the console. Notice that the condition we previously had, ensuring that a node wouldn't be traversed more than once, the isVisited condition, is not needed here, as one fundamental property of trees is the acyclicity. So once a node is traversed, there is no way back to it. Okay, in this first implementation, we are directly printing the value of our nodes to the console. However, what we want is to return the result in the form of a list of lists, meaning for the tree we previously had, the output should be the list of nodes in front of you. And to do that, we need to adapt our current implementation to be aware of each level independently. Now, if you think about it, every time we empty the old elements of our queue, we are starting a new level. What do I mean by old elements? To make things clearer, let's bring back our example. And suppose that the queue we are making use of starts with the root value only. When we empty this queue, meaning we poll the root value, we have completed a level, and then only after this we add the children of this node to it, so the queue is not completely empty and will continue its iteration, but that first level is now complete. Same applies after we poll the next elements. A level is complete. Their children were added to the queue after they were polled. All the old elements that were already in that queue represent a single level. To implement this, what we need to do is keep track of the elements we have inside the queue as soon as we start a new while iteration. This is done by keeping track of the current size of the queue, then a temporary list is created representing the current level we are dealing with. This list will be filled with the nodes that are currently in that queue instead of printing them out. You see only the elements that are in the queue, as soon as we start with the iteration, will be inserted in this list, as these elements constitute a single level. When that level iteration is complete, we add it to our final result and return it to the user. Okay, now that we know how to retrieve the level order list of nodes of a given tree, let's see how we can adapt this implementation to apply on binary trees. Well, it turns out to be easier than you think. All you must do is replace the add all children call with specific invocations to the left child followed by the right child. Oh, and of course the node class used will be a different one, as you can see. Okay, if you were asked this question and were able to answer it, the interviewer may choose to scale it up during an interview. And the first attempt the interviewer might try is ask you to return the bottom-up level order traversal instead of the classic ordering that starts at the root. To do this, you can make use of the same logic we just implemented, but after retrieving the normal level ordering, you reverse the main list of lists that stores each individual level. This can be done by making use of the collections.reversed method, as you can see in front of you. Another way could be to insert your temporary or current level list at the beginning of your final result every time you retrieve a level in the tree. Okay, the second attempt the interviewer might try is ask you to return the zigzag level ordering of a given binary tree. To explain what this is, take this tree as an example alongside its top-down level ordering, which is what we've been discussing since the beginning of the video. To transform this ordering into zigzag level, we must reverse every other level starting from the second level. So, our end result will be the list of lists you see. To implement this, we can use any of the two techniques we just saw. However, this time we must apply them on the individual level lists. Here we went with the collections.reverse approach. Now, to simulate the every other part of the question, we can create a boolean, initialize it to false, and at the end of every traversed level, this boolean will be flipped, indicating that if this level was reversed, then the next one shouldn't be, and if this one wasn't, then the next one should be reversed. The links to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.